What is the Pleistocene? What is the Pleistocene? All right, here's one that you guys want to know. The Pleistocene is the Ice Age. And if you're curious what the Ice Age is, I suggest watching a film titled The Ice Age. Now, my meaning there is that the Disney movie does get the general vibe of it right. And I think the first step in dealing with the Pleistocene, the Ice Age, is to remember there's no dinosaurs here, right? I think we tend to think of it possibly sometimes with dinosaurs because it's other awesome huge creatures, right? It's not dinosaurs though, these are mammals. These are the megafauna, right? Your woolly mammoth, saber-toothed tiger, giant sloth, that's the Pleistocene animals. Now, next, when is the Pleistocene or was the Pleistocene, right? The dates for the Pleistocene, of course, they vary a little bit. This is huge swaths of time. It's basically when the Earth got a little cooler until it warmed up a smidge. Now, the older dates were 1.8 million years until 10,000 years ago. The newer dates are more like 2.5 million years up until 10,000 years ago. Now, this is really recent stuff. So if you say 1.8 million, if you say 2 million, if you say 2.5, you're in the ballpark. You know what I'm saying? If you say 5 million years old, you're wrong. So remember that, though. It's really the last 2 million years of Earth's history minus the last little sliver of 10,000 years. That last 10,000 years is the Holocene. That's the recent time period that we're in, okay? So in this 2 million years, what was the temperature difference? I think that's a common question, right? Like, so, okay, it's the Ice Age. How much colder was it? 50 degrees, 100 degrees, 2 degrees? It varies depending on where you are in the Earth, but think of it as 8 degrees Fahrenheit of difference, right? Around 4 degrees Celsius. So that's not, it ain't a ton. You know what I'm saying? It's not crazy. We're talking 8 degrees. Now, how can 8 degrees make that much difference? Well, at the time, the Earth is slightly tilted, a teeny bit different. It's a tiny bit different on its revolution around the sun, just a tiny smidge of difference. And what happened was that makes you get slightly cooler summers and warmer winters, which feels counterintuitive. But basically, the snow stays on the ground a little longer, it freezes a little longer, you get more snow the next year, and you kind of grow glaciers from there. And also what we want to know about glaciers is that they are, they come and go. And I don't just mean that the glaciers themselves come and go, but the cold snaps come and go. So the Pleistocene is really a time of kind of cold snaps. In the old school, we used to say there were four, right? There were four cold snaps. We named them all after states based on how far the glaciers got down into the United States. There was like the Wisconsin glaciation, the Kansas glaciation, and so on. These days, with better dating methods, we're able to kind of see that there were probably more cold snaps, but that vibe of cold snaps is what I want you guys to remember, right? That there are glacial periods where you have the cold snaps, and then there are interglacials, where it's a little warmer. So it kind of comes and goes, comes and goes. In an overall 8-ish degrees colder world. So that's what you get with the Pleistocene. Now, why might we care for archaeology? Oh, I don't know, because almost every major human evolutionary moment happened in the Pleistocene, right? It happens in this sliver cooler world. Things like, I don't know, how about out of Africa? How about the evolution of Homo erectus into Homo sapiens? You can see how extremely important the knowledge of the Pleistocene is. So just remember that word. I find that The Pleistocene kind of has a PR problem sometimes because of its name, Pleistocene. Wait, is that Holocene or Pliocene? It's one of the scenes, right? Pleistocene. Pleistocene, the Ice Age. Remember it. One thing I forgot to say about the Pleistocene is that sea level was as much as 300 feet below what it is today. Now, why? You got to get the water somewhere for the glaciers, right? So that makes things like finding very early archaeological sites near the coast a little difficult, because you better strap your scuba gear on, man, to find those.